to my channel, or if you are new here, welcome. My name is Ella and I make videos on witchcraft and Wicca. So it is almost time for Beltane, and I'm probably mispronouncing that, I am aware. I believe it is correctly pronounced Baltana, but I may be wrong. I do apologize if I completely butchered that name. In any case, you would most commonly know it as Beltane, or simply May Day. Beltane is one of the greater four Sabbats, and of course, as the name suggests, it is on May 1st. In the Southern Hemisphere, it would be swapped with Samhain, so therefore it would be October 31st or November 1st. Beltane has its roots in pagan Europe, in particular Ireland, Scotland, and the Isle of Man. Though May Day is celebrated really, really widely all over Europe, so you would have it in Germany as well as the Baltics, you would have it in France. It's a very, very common European celebration. Beltane roughly translates into bright fire, which is a theme that you will be seeing throughout all of this Sabbat. Beltane is a fire celebration or a fire festival, honoring fertility and, of course, fire. It's the midpoint between spring equinox and the summer solstice. And traditionally on this day, cattle and other livestock would be brought out into the fields. A time for plantation, would you say that like that? As later on we would then have the harvest festivals. It was very common for people to celebrate this holiday with a bonfire, with a feast, with dancing. All candles or fires would be extinguished in the home, and then a bonfire would be built and everyone would be celebrating around this bonfire, and then later on people would take parts of this fire to light their candles at home or their fires at home. So we really see this kind of connection, this celebration of just fire, of summer is coming. We're already moving into the warmer days. The days are now longer than they used to be. And we're basically heading into the heat of the year. In Wicca, the god and the goddess are now celebrating their marriage and their love and their union. The god plants the seeds for the harvest to come later. So this is really part of that entire wheel of the year. So we see it turning. You know, we had Ostara, where fertility just kind of began to start. The goddess was beginning to become fertile. And now on Beltane, everyone is fertile and we are seeing that love, and we see that mating and that union and that fire being celebrated. Love and commitment are quite thematic for this Sabbat. Therefore, a lot of pagans or Wiccans actually choose to celebrate their hand fasting or marriage on May Day or Beltane. It's very common to honor fire, it's very common to honor the sun god, and also the balance between the goddess and the god, the union between these both. The goddess is now entering her mother stage out of the Trinity. Essentially, the male and female union is really, really celebrated. However, it's of course not exclusive to male and female. In general, it's just love that is being celebrated and union that is being celebrated. Some of the common practices that you may already know are erecting a maypole and to dance around it with ribbons. This is actually something that I saw quite a bit, seeing as I am half German, and I have seen a lot of maypoles. I've seen a lot of people do that entire, you know, dance and everything. It's very, very popular, and I believe it's quite popular in different countries in Europe as well, not just Germany. Bonfires are lit, of course, people are celebrating, people are feasting. This is a great time for baking, it's a great time for using fruit that is seasonal or grains that are seasonal. And one of the fun little activities that people used to do, and some people still do, is to actually jump over the bonfire to cleanse yourself spiritually. So some of the things that we as Wiccans can do to celebrate and honor this day are bake using grains or fruits that are very, very seasonal right now. You can build a mini maypole using a branch and some ribbons that you can tie around it. You can make flower crowns, going outside for nature walks, and of course lighting some candles. It is a fire celebration after all. If you cannot use real fire or real candles, then you can still use that symbolism and, for example, use red or yellow in your altar or maybe in your clothing. This works especially well if you are a broom closet witch, wearing red or wearing yellow, you know, that kind of fiery color. That's a really great idea. You can braid your hair to symbolize the union of the god and the goddess. You can then also put some ribbons in your hair hair or some flowers in your hair. I personally also really like to carry a fiery kind of crystal with me. My favorite one for Beltane is carnelian, seeing that carnelian is literally solidified magma. Amber or bloodstone or citrine are also really, really great crystal options for you if you want to work with crystals during this time. And of course, one of the main activities is to celebrate love or even self-love. So that already is it for Beltane. I do hope you find this video useful. I would actually love to hear how you are going to be celebrating this day. And of course, if you like this video, please don't forget to hit like and subscribe to my channel. It means a lot to me. I also, of course, as always, will have the link to my witchy crystal shop in the description box below, as well as all of the links to my social media. I'm hoping you're staying safe and have a wonderful Beltane. Blessed be.